What is going on, guys? And welcome back to the Intelligent Money Investing Channel. Today we get some great news, some exciting news out of the Robinhood Twitter account that where they actually announced this. That's where I first noticed it. Is that their web app is now available for all Robinhood users. Now this is really exciting news because Robinhood made those three promises about the web app first, options trading, and Robinhood trading for free crypto exchanges. So now we've seen two of those executed so far. I haven't seen crypto personally, and I know a ton of you guys haven't seen options, but absolutely all of us do have access to this Robinhood web app, which is really exciting news. And I think a lot of people don't know about it. I haven't seen many videos on YouTube just yet about that bouncing around. They didn't seem to make a huge announcement on the Robinhood app itself. So I want to kind of make you guys a bit aware of that this is out, and I'm going to show you guys some of the different features and some better features, I think, that this gives you than just the mobile app itself. Before we get into that, I want to tell you guys that I have made a Discord chat. There's a link down in the description if you guys want to join in here. There's some conversation already going on with a few people who just joined in from a comment I made on yesterday's video. So definitely get in here. There's some good entrepreneurship talk, investing talk, and just talk in general. So it's good to have good one-on-one conversations with me as well, because YouTube messaging and commenting is really, really tough to have like an active conversation with. So I'm hoping some people will join in there, have some good investing talks going. And I also want to ask you guys to please drop a like on this video. Really helps out the channel, kind of gives us a little more growth and awareness. We got a lot of support on yesterday's video, which I really appreciate. Now, let's get into the Robinhood web app. So as we can see, this is the homepage right here. You can see your daily chart, 1 week chart. Kind of load this up, 1 month. It all looks pretty nice. Very similar to the mobile app itself, but I think this has a little bit cleaner and better look to it. I really like that it's actively updating in real time. I was a little bit worried we might not have that day chart just because of how the websites work out. As we can see, we have our stocks here on the right side. You can scroll through these with your watch list of cryptos, stocks here, and then down your watch list of stocks and ETFs down on the right side. So this is really exciting how you can have all this all in one page. You can kind of view it all at the same time. Really has a good clean look to it, just like the mobile app does. They did a great job to keep that continuity of from the mobile app to now the online web app. Now we have a For You section, which is pretty cool. So Facebook has more trades than usual, meaning that there's more trades being made today, largely because we know that news came out about Facebook. They're up about 2.5% today after having a really bad week. Southwest, Micron, Amazon. There's just basically some suggestions tailored around your watch list and the stocks you own, which is really cool. You don't really get that on the mobile app, so it's kind of giving you some more suggestions for your next investment and some more stocks to look into that you might not know about beforehand. You might, for some reason, you might not have known that Southwest was a publicly traded thing, like a company, even though you see commercials about it all the time. Random stuff like that kind of gives you more awareness in the market, especially for a newer investor. Now, another section I'm really excited about, top movers. So you can see the biggest movers percentage-wise for the day. As we can see today, General Mills about down 9.5%, Range Resources up 6.25%, Newfield Exploration up 6%, and Chipotle up 5.7%. I'm going to have to look into that and see what happened with Chipotle, because we know Chipotle has been a stock that's had a ton of downward momentum over the last few years. And then down here, we get recent news, which are articles tailored around what the stocks you own and have on your watch list. So as you guys can see, Yahoo Finance on Coca-Cola, Yahoo Finance on Apple, Microsoft, Business Insider on GE. So a lot of cool stuff here, really tailored around all of the stocks that you own. So that way you're not just getting a bunch of random articles pushed at you that aren't really going to be applicable to your portfolio, but you're actually going to be able to read up on articles and news about the stock, the individual stocks that you own, so you can stay up to date with what's going on with your investments, which I think is really cool. It is a great feature. I know they have that on the Robinhood app, but this is more interactive. You can see the pictures instead of just the titles and a little bit more information here. Now, there's also a notifications tab here where you can check a bunch of your dividends and stuff. I wish I could go into my history and account, but that gives a little bit too much personal information, and I don't want to risk myself being exposed to any sort of hack or anything like that. Now, there's also with these, there's also it's called the collections tab. So through these collections, there's things like top 100 traded stocks, stuff like that, which can be really, really exciting to go through. And I'm going to click at a couple individual stocks just to kind of see how they go. I think let's start out with SPY, very popular ETF, S&P 500 ETF. And at the top, you can see 100. This is the categories it falls under: 100 most popular mutual fund, finance. And then on here, you can see 21,500 people own SPDR, S&P 500 ETF Trust on Robinhood. So that's cool. You can see the type of ownership that and how common they are to buy on Robinhood. And once we go through here, you can see total equity in here, total return, today's return, average cost, portfolio diversity. As you guys can see, this is very high for me, about 24%. Then about, you can see the statistics of it, and then down here, these collections once again. Price paid on Robinhood. Oh, I actually haven't seen this feature yet. So the average price paid is that my price or is that everybody's price? My average cost is $2.42. So everybody, the average price that a Robinhood user paid is $2.55, and we're at $2.72 now. So people are up about 7%, which is cool. We're a little bit lower than our 52-week high at $2.86. And as you can see, I have a few pending dividends here. Then there's also a people also bought section at the bottom, which is really, really cool. See more suggestions for you guys tailored around the stocks that you have. And now you have buy and sell orders on the right side here. Unfortunately, you can't trade options, it seems like, on here just yet, which is unfortunate. But right now on the mobile app, I'm sure for the people who have options, they'll be rolling that out on the web app relatively soon. Now let's look at the 100 most popular before we wrap this up here. As you guys can see, Apple, it makes sense that the biggest company in the world is number one on the 100 most popular. But we can see symbol price, today's market movement, the market cap, popularity being the amount of people owning this stock on the Robinhood app, and then 62% analyst ratings, like the buy and sell ratings. I'm not really sure how accurate these are going to be. I would do your own research and not just listen to these analyst ratings. Just because, like, GoPro has a 0% buy rating doesn't mean it has no upside. Like, even though I don't think it has upside, and like so people like maybe financial education might think you should get in a GoPro. But it may, like something like Facebook, 89% buy, that doesn't mean you have to go out and get a share of Facebook. That's the best opportunity out there. So there's a lot of other factors when going in to own a stock. So definitely do your own research before buying in. So I want you guys to comment down below. What do you guys think about this new feature on the Robinhood the web app? Are you going to use this more than just the phone app? Let me know down below. Don't forget to check out this Discord chat and also hit a like down below if you could. That'd be absolutely great. Discord chat's in the description, and if you want to download the Robinhood app, hit that link in the description. We'll both get a free stock. Hope you guys have enjoyed this video. Thank you for watching, and I will see you in the next one.